A new life, a new beginning for 163 Syrian refugees who arrived in Canada.
Exhausted but thrilled and determined, thousands of migrants are welcomed in Austria and Germany.
They're some of the 30% of Spanish youths who go to university. But with the long recession, they're worried that their degrees won't help.
According to the International Labour Organization, last year, 73.3 million people under the age of 24 were out of work.
People are still worried about immigration. Why do you think that still that is?
Después de la guerra civil, bueno, pues en base a la miseria que había en España en aquel momento, pues se vieron forzados a buscar un nuevo horizonte. En este caso, emigraron hacia Latinoamérica, concretamente a Venezuela. Primero fue mi padre, después de 8 años se marchó mi madre.
Migrants
and refugees
take care of this family
looking for work.
Your age is also an issue.
Young people are 3 times more likely to be out of work than older adults.
In recent weeks, we've seen a vast increase in the numbers arriving across the eastern Mediterranean from Turkey. More than 150,000 people have attempted that route since January.
You know, in Europe, I think people like Chancellor Merkel have taken a very courageous stance in saying it is our moral obligation as fellow human beings to help people who are
thank you, Estrella. Thank you, Germany.
Even though these people are obviously absolutely exhausted, many of them have been on the road for months, have endured horrible things while they were trying to make their way over here.
Wir können uns von den globalen Ereignissen nicht mehr entkoppeln.
My mom, I cannot forget her.
You can still see smiles on almost everybody's faces simply because they're so happy to finally have made it.
Because we are crossing the roads in the red line.
Migración, en sencillas palabras, significa desplazarse de un país a otro debido a un motivo laboral o académico. También significa crecer como persona y aprender a ser tolerante, respetando otras opiniones y otras culturas. Sin embargo, para mí ha significado mucho más que eso. Cuando tenía 17 años, fui 9 meses a Estados Unidos para poder aprender inglés. Y este año he hecho mi Erasmus en Reino Unido. Y ambas experiencias han sido muy importantes para mí.
And it is absolutely right that Britain should fulfill its moral responsibility to help those refugees, just as we've done so proudly throughout our history.
No one risks the lives of their children in this way except out of utter desperation.
Here I see that I don't have many opportunities.
Pero si hay algún país que está preparado para responder a este reto es España, porque esa es la voluntad y el deseo de los españoles.
It's not only me, it's everybody.
We passed through a lot of stress, we passed through the desert, it's just like a hell, nobody to help. Few survived it, many died in the desert.
Thousands of volunteers are stepping up and following her lead. They bring supplies, toys, and welcoming smiles to refugees.
We have an inescapable moral duty to help refugees.
They're talking here about a lost generation.
Greeted with cheers at this.
Because it's processing hundreds of applicants each day.
29% of France's youth believe the economic future is so bleak that they are considering moving abroad.
He and thousands like him are leaving Ireland in search of work.
I know many people who have lost confidence.
Noch nie seit dem Zweiten Weltkrieg waren so viele Menschen auf der Flucht wie heute. Etwa 60 Millionen.
Since the Syria conflict began in 2011, I have made 11 visits to Syrian refugees in Iraq, Jordan, Lebanon, Turkey, and Malta. I wish that some of the Syrians I have met could be here today.
They are parents, they are children, they are orphans, that we do not close our hearts to these victims.
Culture of welcome.
Well, it's a possibility.
It is sickening to see thousands of refugees drowning on the doorstep of the world's wealthiest continent.
There is no difference between us. So don't be afraid of us. We are human, just like we don't have weapons. We have this, we want. It's our leg. Our legs.